Second chapter, linear equations in one variable. First of all, we discuss about the expressions, algebraic expressions and the algebraic equations. Okay, expressions is nothing but combination of the constants and variables. Constants nothing but numbers 1, 2, 3, either 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 plus or minus 3, so on, whatever the numbers we are taking. Okay, they're integers or rational numbers, whatever the numbers, those are called as constants. Next, variables. Variables means we are taking variables notation denoted as the small alphabets. Okay. In general, we are taking, suppose x comma y comma z small p q r or a b c also. Okay, but generally expressing the, we don't know the constants and we don't know the variable values. If we are taking A, B, C or rational numbers, the rational numbers are also, if we can choose any rational numbers. Suppose in the rational number set, we are choosing any three rational numbers, means A, B, C, these are also denoted by the small alphabets. But rational numbers means those are called as the constants. Okay, these rational numbers means numbers is nothing but constants. And variables, suppose we are taking x, y, z or the variables. Okay, for example, variables are denoted by the small alphabets, constants also denoted by the small alphabets. But here we are taking the small constants are taking the alphabets from A, the variables are taking from last, it's from first, from last. Now the expression, if we are taking the expression with the variables means, suppose ax plus by plus cz, this is the expression. Okay, this expression is equal to any we are taking, suppose capital A or capital P or anything. Okay, in this, how many variables are there? X comma y comma z. The expression in three variables is taking as ax plus by plus cz. In that, a, b, c are constants, x, y, z are variables. This expression is called as combination with the variables and constants by using of the algebraic expressions. Okay, algebraic operations. Algebraic expressions mean...
Understood. Hello.
Variable.
Hello.
So the expression is P of x comma y comma z means it can be expressed with the variables and constant with the algebraic operations. Those are addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Okay. Suppose I'm taking one expression, 2 by 3 x plus y minus z is there, plus 3. In this case, multiplication is there. 2 by 3 is the division. This is a rational number, the product of one constant and variable. So multiplication is there. In between of the two terms, addition and subtraction is there. This is one type of the expression. This expression having the variables 3, x, y, z or the three variables. In this, constants are, y having no constant means it is indirectly 1 into y is y. Minus 1 into z is z, plus 3. Okay, this is the sum expression. When we are taking the equations, algebraic equations, equation is nothing but whatever the expression is there, that expression is taking to equal to 0. That is equate to 0, then this is called as the equation. It is the equation. Okay, In this, the equation having the three variables here clearly x, y, z are variables, and a, b, c are the constants, unknown constants here. Okay, this expression is called as the algebraic expression. When we can discuss about the linear, quadratic, cubic, all such type of the equations. For example, in your standard, we are discussing only one variable. One variable means x be a variable. This variable combined with the algebraic operations, either plus, minus, multiplication, and division, the combination of the constants. For example, I am taking one expression, 2x plus 3. This is one type of the expression. This expression having only one variable, so it is called as the one variable expression. Okay, when it is equal to zero, this is called as equation. Okay, one variable equation. Here in this standard, we are discussing linear equations. Linear equations in one variable. Linear equations in one variable. The expression is involved in one variable and equate to zero, then that is called as the equation. When we can take the variable degree is one, here x is nothing but indirectly that is equal to x degree one. The degree of the variable is one. Degree of the variable, whatever the variable, is equal to one, such type of the equation is called as linear equation. Such type of equation is called as linear equation. Okay, linear equation means we are concentrating variable degree. If, for example, I am taking 5y minus 3 is equal to 0. In this y is a variable, variable degree is 1. So it is a linear equation. And 3p plus 10 equal to 0. This is a, p is a variable, the p degree is 1. So it is a linear equation. The variable degree is 1. Such type of equations is called as the linear equation. Okay, here, just you can observe whatever the equal to something is there, that is called as the equation. Okay, the equation having how many variables? It is clearly having one variable, so it is called as the one variable equation. And we can observe that variable degree is how much. If the degree is one, variable degree is one, clearly we can say that it is a linear equation of the one variable. Okay, in this 5, 3 are constants, and 5 and y means in between of y variable and 5 constant, the algebraic operation is there, that is multiplication. 5 into y, 5y minus 3. Then these two terms are related with the negative sign, minus, subtraction. So this is the expression. When the expression is equal to something, either it is equal to zero or any constant or any expression, so such type of the expression is called as equation, if it is taken to equal. Okay, here in this equation, the equal left side terms is the left hand side. Equal right side terms, right hand side. Okay, equal left side terms are called as left hand side. Equal right side is called as right hand side. Okay, the expression, whatever the terms are there, the equality after what is there, that is right hand side. Equality before what is there, that is left hand side. Okay, in this, generally linear equation means variable degree. We can concentrate about the degree of the variable, which is equal to one, linear. In the such type of equations, more are also there, quadratic equation, cubic equation, okay, the polynomials. Quadratic equation means degree is 2, that is called as quadratic equation. Cubic means degree is 3, cubic equations. If degree is 4, higher order equations, okay, higher degree equations, okay. And here one more example, here I have taken one example, ax plus by plus cz. It has 3 variables, so it is not a one variable equation. Three variable equation. And one more thing, you concentrate about variables degree, what is there. Here clearly variable degree is 1. For 3 variables degree 1, so it is called as linear equation in 3 variables. Okay, linear equation in 3 variables. In this standard, we are discussing only for 1 variable linear equations. Okay, the basic thing we can concentrate about the left hand side and right hand side. How to find out the solution of such linear equations? Solution. In the solution, taking variables one side, transpose method. One side, it is called as the transpose method, and constants another side. Then simplify, we are getting the variable value. That variable value is called as the solution of the given equation, whatever the thing. If in that case, we are discussing some methods, okay? Solving equations which have linear expressions on one side and numbers on the other side. Other side. In these cases are there. First case is solving equations. That is nothing but variables one side, constants another side, and simplify it, then we are getting the solution. Solving equations which have linear expressions on one side and numbers on the other side. That is a solution. Solving equations which have linear expressions one side, constants are another side. I'm taking one problem. Find the solution of first one, 2x minus 3 equal to 7. Second one, 2y plus 9 equal to 4. Third one, x by 3 plus 5 by 2 equal to minus 3 by 2. Fourth one, 15 by 4 minus 7x equal to 9. See here, the first problem is 2x minus 3 equal to 7. Here, which have linear equations, one side and the numbers are another side, means here 2x minus 3 equal to 7 is there. When we add both sides, plus 3 on both sides, what we are getting? 2x minus 3 plus 3 equal to 7 plus 3. Minus 3 plus 3, it becomes 0. So 2x equal to 10. Next, this equation is divides with 2. When it is divides with 2, so both sides divides with 2 on both sides. 2x by 2 equal to 10 by 2. 2 1s are 2 1s are. 2 1s are 2 5s are. From this, the solution of the equation x equal to 5. That is the solution. Okay. Try to balance. And this is also, I am telling the one more method. So transpose method. Transpose method means it is taking to another side. That will come in the next exercise. Just it is the by adding, dividing, multiplying this method in the first exercise. Okay. Second one. 2y plus 9 equal to 4. Elimination of the left side, the constant elimination. For that, what we can do? Add with minus 9 on both sides. Here plus 9 is there. We know that plus 9 additive inverse is minus 9. So 2y plus 9, both sides means minus 9 left hand side, minus 9 right hand side. Plus 9 minus 9 becomes 0. It is equal to 2y. 2y equal to 9 is bigger number, has negative sign. 4 is smaller number, positive sign. Subtract from one to another. Bigger number has which sign? The same sign will come from for the subtraction number. So it is minus 5. Next step, divide with 2 on both sides. So 2y by 2 equal to minus 5 by 2. 2 1s are 2 1s are. So what is the solution? Y equal to minus 5 by 2. Okay. Third one. X by 3 plus 5 by 2 equal to minus 3 by 2. Fourth one. 15 by 4 minus 7x equal to 9. Third one, add with minus 5 by 2 on both sides. The same number, what is the variable having which term? The left hand side, what is the constant term is there? Just you can observe that taking opposite sign. Here plus 5 by 2 is there. We add with minus 5 by 2 on both sides. So x by 3 plus 5 by 2 minus 5 by 2 left hand side. Right hand side also minus 5 by 2. But right hand term is minus 3 by 2. Okay. Here plus 5 by 2 minus 5 by 2 get cancelled. Then 1 minus 1 it becomes 0. So x by 3 equal to minus the right hand side fractions are like fractions taking the LCM. 2 is the LCM. Okay. This is minus 3 minus 5. It is minus 8 by 2. Okay. Next, multiply the above expression. The above equation is multiply with 3 on both sides. So x by 3 into 3 equal to minus 8 by 2 into 3. This 3 1s are 3 1s are get cancelled. X equal to 8 3s are 24 with negative sign. 24 by 2, or here we are taking 2 1s are 2 2 12s are. So minus 12. What is the answer? X equal to minus 12 is the answer. Okay, that is the solution. X value is the solution of that equation. The same way, fourth one, here plus 15 by 4 is there. So add both sides with minus 15 by 4 on both sides. So minus 15 by 4 plus 15 by 4 minus 7x equal to minus 15 by 4 plus 9. Or 9 minus 15 by 4, whatever the order. Here minus 15 by 4 plus 15 by 4 get cancelled. Minus 7x equal to the right hand side taking the LCM. 4 is the LCM. 1 and 4 LCM is 4. Here multiply with 4 to convert into like fractions. Minus 15 plus 9 4s are 36. It is minus 7x equal to plus 36 minus 15 is plus 21 by 4. Next, divide with minus 7 on both sides. So minus 7x by minus 7 equal to 21 by 4 into 1 by minus 7. Minus minus cancel, 7 ones are 7 ones are. Here 7 ones are 7 threes are. From this, x equal to denominator negative is taking to numerator after multiplying with minus 1, minus 3 by 4. The solution of the given equation is x equal to minus 3 by 4. Okay. First exercise in the second chapter, solve the following equations. First one, x minus 2 equal to 7. Second one, y plus 3 equal to 10. Third one, 6 equal to z plus 2. Fourth one, 3 by 7 plus x equal to 17 by 7. Fifth one, 6x equal to 12. Sixth one, t by 5 equal to 10. Seventh one, 2x by 3 equal to 18. Eighth one, 1.6 equal to y by 1.5. Ninth one, 7x minus 9 equal to 16. Tenth one, 14y minus 8 equal to 13. 11th one, 17 plus 6p equal to 9. 12th one, x by 3 plus 1 equal to 7 by 15. The first solution, x minus 2 equal to 7. The x variable is in left side. It has the constant minus 2. So simply we add plus 2 on both sides. So x minus 2 plus 2 equal to 7 plus 2. Both sides add plus 2. Minus 2 plus 2 cancel. It is x equal to 7 plus 2 is equal to 9. 9 is the solution of the given equation. Simply here minus 2 is taking to right hand side. Then minus 2 becomes a plus 2. So x equal to 7 plus 2 is the 9. That is the transpose method. Second solution, y plus 3 equal to 10. Here plus 3 means y side plus 3 constant is there. So we eliminate that constant by adding with minus 3 on both sides. So y plus 3 minus 3 equal to 10 minus 3. Plus 3 minus 3 get cancelled. Y equal to 10 minus 3 is the 7. So 7 is the solution of the given linear equation. Third one, 6 equal to z plus 2. So here z side plus 2 is a constant. So add minus 2 on both sides to elimination of the constant for the variable side. So 6 minus 2 equal to z plus 2 minus 2. Plus 2 minus 2 cancel. 6 minus 2 is the 4. 4 equal to z. Okay. Next, fourth one. 3 by 7 plus x equal to 17 by 7. The x variable side, 3 by 7 is a constant to eliminate that plus 3 by 7. So add with minus 3 by 7 on both sides. So minus 3 by 7 plus 3 by 7 plus x equal to minus 3 by 7 plus 17 by 7. Plus 3 by 7 minus 3 by 7 get cancelled. So the right hand side simplification, these two fractions are like fractions. Taking the LCM, LCM is the 7. Minus 3 plus 17. 17 minus 3 is 14 by 7. 7 ones are 7 twos are. So x is equal to 2 is the solution. You can check out 3 by 7 plus 2. Taking LCM, 7 twos are 14 plus 3, 17 by 7. Next, fifth one. 6x equal to 12. The whole equation is divided with 6. Divide with 6 on both sides. So 6x by 6 equal to 12 by 6. 6 ones are 6. 6 ones are 6 twos are 12. So x equal to 2 is the solution. Sixth problem. T by 5 equal to 10. T has the divisor 5. So we multiply with 5 on both sides. So T by 5 into 5 equal to 10 into 5. 5 ones are 5 ones are. T ones are T equal to 10 5s are 50. Okay. Seventh one. 2x by 3 equal to 18. Here x has the coefficient 2 by 3. So it is divides the reciprocal, that is 3 by 2. Or first we multiply with 3, then divide with 2. Two cases we can. Simply 2 by 3 reciprocal. 1 by 2 by 3 means 3 by 2. Multiply with 3 by 2 or divide with 2 by 3, whatever the thing here we are taking. Either multiply with 3 by 2 or divide with 2 by 3. Okay? On both sides. 2x by 3 into 3 by 2 equal to 18 into 3 by 2. 2 ones are 2 9s are 18, 2 1s are 2 1s are, 3 1s are 3 1s are. So x equal to 9 3s are 27. Or if we divide with 2 by 3 means 2x by 3 divides with 2 by 3 equal to 18 divides with 2 by 3. So it becomes 2 by 3x into reciprocal of this fraction is 3 by 2 equal to 18 into 3 by 2. We are getting the same. Eighth one. 1.6 equal to y divides with 1.5. Y having the denominator 1.5, so we should multiply the whole equation with 1.5. on both sides. So 1.6 into 1.5 equal to y ratio 1.5 into 1.5. 1.5 ones are 1.5 ones are. Here y equal to 15 6 are 90. 9 is the carry. 15 ones are 15 plus 9, 24. After two digits before take point, 1, 2, 2.4. So y equal to 2.4. Ninth one. Do homework 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th.